Welcome students. In the last class we have discussed how to find inverse of a matrix by using determinants, that is by using the formula A inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A, and inverse exists only if determinant of A not equal to 0. If determinant of A equal to 0, this will be 1 by 0, so in that case inverse we cannot find. So inverse does not exist if determinant of A equal to 0. That means if a matrix A is singular, singular means determinant of A equal to 0, then inverse does not exist. And if a matrix A is non-singular, non-singular means determinant of A not equal to 0, then we can find inverse of the matrix. Today we can do some more questions from this section. Okay. So first question. If A equal to matrix 2, lambda minus 3, 0, 2, 5, 1, 1, 3, then find the value of lambda for which A inverse exists. A inverse exists means determinant of A not equal to 0. So determinant of A not equal to 0. That means you have to find the value of determinant. So determinant of 2, lambda minus 3, 0, 2, 5, and third row is 1, 1, 3. This should be not equal to 0. Now we can expand this determinant along first row. We can expand through any row or any column. Here I am expanding along first row. So we will get 2 into 6. 6 minus 5. That is 1. Okay. Minus lambda into 0 minus 5. That is minus 5. Minus 3 into 0 minus 2. Minus 2. Which is not equal to 0. It is 2 plus 5 lambda plus 6 is not equal to 0. So what is value of lambda? 5 lambda plus 8 not equal to 0 means 5 lambda not equal to minus 8. So we will get lambda equal to lambda not equal to minus 8 by 5. So lambda can be any value except minus 8 by 5. That is the answer. So conclusion is, lambda can be any value except or other than minus 8 by 5. Lambda can be any value other than minus 8 by 5. Okay. Second question. If A equal to matrix 3, K, 4, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 0, then find the value of lambda such that A inverse does not exist. A inverse does not exist if determinant of A equal to 0. A inverse exists if determinant of A not equal to 0. Here, determinant of A equal to 0. That means you have to find determinant of 3, K, 4, 1, 2, 1, 1, 1, 0. This is equal to 0. By using this equation, you have to find the value of K. So, we can expand along first row. We get 3 into 0 minus 1. That is 3 into minus 1, then minus k into 0 minus 1, here also it is minus 1, plus 4 into 1 minus 2, 1 minus 2 equal to again minus 1 equal to 0. This one you can simplify, we will get minus 3 plus k minus 4 equal to 0. So what is the value of k? K equal to 7. So now consider another question. That is, if A equal matrix 3, 4, 5, 6, then find A inverse whole transpose, A transpose whole inverse. We can just check whether A inverse whole transpose is equal to A transpose whole inverse. So first we can find A inverse. A inverse, we have one direct formula, that is 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. So first we can find determinant of A. So what is determinant of A? Determinant of A equal to determinant of 3, 4, 5, 6. That is 18 minus 20 minus 2. So this is not equal to 0. That means A inverse exists. Now it is adjoint of A. Since it is a 2 by 2 matrix, we can find adjoint directly. But it is adjoint. This you have to interchange diagonal elements. 6, you have to keep these two elements same, but you have to multiply with minus. So, minus 4, minus 5, this will be 3. It is adjoined. So A inverse equal to 1 by minus 2. That is minus 1 by 2 into adjoint. Adjoint is 6 minus 4 minus 5, 3. Now we can go for our second sub-question, that is A inverse whole transpose. So you have to find transpose of A inverse. So A inverse whole transpose we can find directly. That means transpose of this matrix. Minus 1 by 2 will be same. Then you have to find transpose of A inverse. So first row changes to first column. That is 6 minus 4. And second row changes to second column. Minus 5, 3. This one is A inverse whole transpose. Now we can find our third question. That is A transpose whole inverse. For that first you have to find A transpose. That is A transpose of A. That is equal to matrix 3, 4. First row changes to first column and second row changes to second column. Now we want to find inverse of this matrix. So by definition, A transpose whole inverse will be 1 by determinant of A transpose, right, into adjoint of A transpose, because A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. B inverse equal to 1 by determinant of B into adjoint of B. Therefore, A transpose whole inverse will be equal to 1 by determinant of A transpose into adjoint of A transpose. First, we can find determinant of A transpose. That means determinant of this matrix. That is 3, 5, 4, 6. This value is equal to 18 minus 20, that is minus 2. Now we can find adjoint of A transpose. Adjoint of A transpose is equal to adjoint of this matrix. This you have to interchange diagonal elements. These two elements you have to keep same, but you have to multiply with minus. It will be minus 5, minus 4. Therefore, A transpose whole inverse, this will be equal to 1 by determinant of A transpose, that is 1 by minus 2 into adjoint of A transpose, that is 6 minus 5 minus 4, 3. Actually, these two are same, right? This one and this. So, A inverse whole transpose, this one result, A inverse whole transpose, this is equal to A transpose whole inverse. Okay. Next question. If A equal to matrix 2, 1, 1, 3 and B equal to 1, 1, 2, 3, find AB inverse. AB whole inverse. What is the formula to find AB whole inverse? That is B inverse into A inverse that you studied in last class. AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. Okay, so first we can find B inverse, then A inverse, then we can multiply those two matrices. So B inverse is equal to, by formula it is 1 by determinant of B into adjoint of B. Notice determinant of B. Determinant of B means determinant of 1, 1, 2, 3. That is equal to 3 minus 2, 1. It is not equal to 0, therefore B inverse exists. And adjoint of B we can find directly since it is a 2 by 2 matrix. What is adjoint of B? This you have to interchange diagonal elements 3, 1. These two elements you have to keep, but you have to multiply with minus. So minus 1, minus 2. This one is adjoint of B. Therefore, B inverse equal to 1 by determinant of B, 1 by 1, into matrix 3, minus 1, minus 2, 1. Now we can find A inverse. So A inverse equal to, by definition, 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. So first we can find determinant of A. What is determinant of A? It is determinant of 2, 1, 1, 3. That is equal to 6 minus 1, 5. Since 5 is not equal to 0, A inverse exists. So now you have to find adjoint of A. that is adjoint of A, we can find directly, that is 3 minus 1 minus 1, 2. Right. Since it is a 2-by-2 matrix, we can find adjoint directly. Okay, now A inverse equal to, A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A, that is 1 by 5 into adjoint. Adjoint is 3 minus 1 minus 1, 2. Now you have to multiply B inverse and A inverse. So for B inverse into A inverse. B inverse and A inverse is not equal to A inverse into B inverse because matrix multiplication is not commutative. So first you have to write B inverse itself. So B inverse equal to matrix 3 minus 1 minus 2 1 into A inverse, that is 1 by 5 into matrix. 1 by 5 into matrix 3 minus 1 minus 1 2. Okay. Here you have to note down one step. You should not multiply this matrix with 1 by 5. Then further calculation will be difficult. We can multiply with 1 by 5 at last. So this is equal to 1 by 5 into matrix 3 minus 1 minus 2 1 into matrix 3 minus 1 minus 1 2. When we multiply these two matrices, what will get? 1 by 5 into. Answer will be a 2 by 2 matrix. So in order to get A11, you have to take first row and first column. 9, 9 plus 1, 10, then minus 3 minus 2, that is minus 5. Second row and first column, minus 6 minus 1, minus 6 minus 1, minus 7. Then second row, second column, plus 2 plus 2, 2 plus 2, 4 you get. So this one is B inverse and A inverse, that is AB whole inverse, AB whole inverse. Otherwise, we have one more formula. By direct formula also, we can find AB whole inverse by using 1 by determinant of AB into adjoint of AB. Okay. But this method is simple. Right? Next question. If A equal to matrix 2, 1, 1, 3 and B inverse is equal to 1 by 3 into matrix 0, 1, minus 1, 2, then find AB whole inverse. AB whole inverse, we have one formula. AB whole inverse is equal to B inverse into A inverse. So B inverse is already given. So you have to find just A inverse. A inverse. A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A into adjoint of A. This type of question you can expect for 2 marks. Okay. So first we can find determinant of A. Determinant of A equal to determinant of 2, 1, 1, 3. That is 6 minus 1, 5. And adjoint of A also we can find directly. That is 3 minus 1, minus 1, 2. This you have to interchange diagonal elements and this you have to keep same but multiply with minus. Therefore, A inverse, that is A inverse, 1 by 5 into matrix. Matrix 3 minus 1 minus 1, 2. Now we can find AB whole inverse. AB whole inverse, that is equal to B inverse into A inverse. B inverse is equal to 1 by 3 into matrix 0, 1, minus 1, 2. What about A inverse? A inverse equal to 1 by 5 into matrix 3, minus 1, minus 1, 2. So we can multiply these two numbers together, these two matrices together. This one we can rearrange as 1 by 3 into 1 by 5 into matrix 0, 1, minus 1, 2 into 3, minus 1, minus 1, 2. So these two matrices you can multiply first. At last you can multiply with 1 by 15. This answer is 1 by 15 into matrix. First row, first column, 0, then minus 1. Okay, minus 1. Then first row, second column, 0 plus 2. That is 2. Second row, first column, minus 3 minus 2, minus 5. Then second row, second column, 1 plus 4 equal to 5. Therefore, AB whole inverse equal to 1 by 15 into minus 1, 2, minus 5, 5. Okay. Next question. If A is a 3 by 3 invertible matrix, means inverse exists, then what will be the value of K if determinant of A inverse is equal to determinant of A all raised to K? That is, determinant of A inverse is equal to determinant of A all raised to K. It is given. Now, by using this equation, you have to find the value of K. We know that what is determinant of A inverse? Determinant of A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A. Right. Right hand side is determinant of A raised to K. Just you have to simplify this one. What is 1 by determinant of A? That is determinant of A raised to minus 1 is equal to determinant of A raised to K. Now we can equate both sides. So we'll get K equal to minus 1. Very simple question. This type of question you can expect for 1 mark. Consider another question. If A equal to matrix 2, 3, 1, 4, find the determinant of A cube. Determinant of A cube is equal to determinant of A whole cube. So by using this formula, you can find answer very easily. Otherwise, you have to multiply matrix A 3 times. A into A square, A square into A cube. Then you have to find determinant of A. It will be a lengthy process. But by using this formula, you will get answer very easily. Determinant of A, that is determinant of 2, 3, 1, 4. 8 minus 3 equal to 5. Therefore, determinant of A whole cube is equal to 5 cube. That is 5 cube, 125. Okay, we can do one more question. If A and B are matrices of order 3 and determinant of A equal to 2 and determinant of AB whole inverse is equal to minus 1 by 6, then find determinant of B. So how we can find determinant of B? Determinant of AB whole inverse. We know that determinant of, what is determinant of A inverse? Determinant of A inverse equal to 1 by determinant of A. Same property we can use here. Determinant of AB whole inverse is equal to 1 by determinant of AB. This is given as minus 1 by 6. Right. Now, what is determinant of AB? Determinant of A into determinant of B. That is equal to minus 1 by 6. Determinant of A is given as 2. So, 1 by 2 into determinant of B equal to minus 1 by 6. Therefore, determinant of B is equal to minus 3. Right, this you have to cross multiply. So, dear students, we can conclude today's session. In the next class, we will study another topic. Okay, thank you.